from North Carolina. It's the RH3 Show.
I wasn't scared to go over the edge.
Look, I do this for nobody but my co-host. Because God first, didn't my co-host.
I done been doubted, I done been counted out, I done been overlooked.
Because your listeners are, you know, international, they're worldwide.
The RH3 Show starts right now.
I gotta praise because he set me free. Christ said he paid for me at Calvary. I'm gonna dance and there's no stopping me. Don't ever change the life.
What's going on, everybody? What's up, y'all? This your boy Rufus, your boy Red, and I am the host of the RH3 Show. Welcome to another great, great day. Hope y'all are doing good. Y'all, let's get started. It's time for the Inside Scoop with Rufus News. We got some good news today, so let's go ahead and get started. Got to catch up on the news regarding politics, or if you want to know news about the TV, movies, sports, and or the music industry, be it if it's in gospel or any other entertainment genre, well, it is time for the Inside Scoop with Rufus right here on the RH3 Show. All right, thank you for that introduction. It's time for the Inside Scoop with Rufus News. And this is where I give you all my honest, my unscripted opinion on world and entertainment news, y'all. Chart-topping artist Miranda Curtis releases a potent testament to faith, loss, healing, strength, declaring hope and salvation in her latest album, Die to Live, which is available now. Y'all, it's available now. The acclaimed singer, songwriter has crafted her most vulnerable and versatile album yet on a 15-track project following her release of her live album in 2018. Y'all, it's out now. Die to Live. Miranda Curtis. Hold on, y'all. I had to fix my hat because my hat was about to fall off. My beanie. Y'all, anything can happen here. But anyway, y'all, Miranda is one of my favorite artists. She's one of my favorite artists, and I like her. I really, really do. I like Miranda. She's one of my favorite artists. And, I love her. She's a beautiful songstress. I love Miranda Curtis. And I love how she sing, "Nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you." I love her. So, she's awesome and incredible. She's awesome. But anyway, go check out her album. I'm not here to push and promote and whatever and, you know, do all of that. But, you know, hey, check it out. Anyway, let's move on. Inspirational Christian and gospel recording artist Greg Monk releases new and uplifting single, Better Plan. I never heard of him. But inspirational Christian and gospel recording artist Greg Monk releases another warm heart, full-hearted, relatable song that, we all have dreams and plans, but somehow they don't always work out the way we think they would. And we eventually come to realize that God has a better plan. But Better Plan is fused with ballad and soulful vocals and vibes that'll take you on a journey. I want to hear that. I really do. And so that sounds like it's going to be a good one. Sounds like it's going to be a good one. Some World news, Ahmaud Arbery's killers were found guilty on federal hate crime charges. I don't know, that other woman who killed, who was on trial here in the States, I think she didn't get much. She didn't get much. And so I don't want to quote how much time she, I don't even have the paperwork and the notes in my, I know a lot of folks are just devastated on how much time that she got, but it wasn't a lot at all. It wasn't a lot at all. It wasn't a lot at all. Yesterday, y'all, I mentioned about Kanye West. I mentioned about Kanye West, and I forgot to talk about him. But he have an album. Not an album, but he has his documentary out. And a lot of people were really talking about. And I think, let me search something really quick. Y'all know, I was talking a lot about this documentary, not documentary, but talking about, yes. I was talking a lot about, not the documentary itself, but talking about Kanye West, period, on how he was acting. And, you know, this man, he really blows me, y'all. He really blows me on how he's acting. But, honestly, this guy is very intelligent. He's very intelligent. But he's kind of, you know, a bit, you know, loose. And so I got seven things that you could take from the documentary. I haven't seen it, but I got notes that I pulled from Instagram. And that's how I say it that way because of how somebody else say it. But you know, seven things that you can pull from it. Number one, he's always been the same Kanye. Absolutely, you know, absolutely nothing has changed. He's always been the same one. You know, the only difference is that, you know, he has evolved and had so many life experiences and a plethora of highs and lows with fame. And so, you know, I kind of get, you know, how the way he is, but he needs to acknowledge, you know, it's kind of sad that you have to say he needs help, but in his mind, he don't think it. But he does. For real. And even back in the day when Oprah Winfrey had her, you know, talk show, he was on there. And it was just a point of, you know, he had faith in himself that he could do this, that, and the third. And so, yeah. He had faith in himself that he could do this, that, and the third, you know, what have you. And so, yeah. But it's just, it's kind of strange to say whatever, you know, and I don't want to get to the point to where I'm, you know, kind of pointing fingers and, you know, this, that, and the third, because I'll get into another path of you know, bit name calling. But it's just a point of, I wish that he would get help before somebody else get hurt. That's what I'm trying to say, you know, because other people's lives are at stake, not only his. Number two, too many people gave up on this dude. From his mentors to his best friends that he grew up with, you know, and when he needed help the most, no one came to help him. And, you know, no one. But he needed the, you know, You know, no one came when he needed help. No one came. But when you are a good person, no one will reciprocate the same feelings towards you, you know, and you know, and some relationships aren't worth salvaging. And that's, you know, what he, you know, pulled from this. Number three, he has a childlike personality, and it's so funny, you know, it's kind of funny to watch, but, you know, but again, you know, kind of need, you know, people need to watch it because that could be his cry out, you know, his younger self in an adult form. It's a scene, number four, it's a scene where he gave a lady money to buy some food after getting his record deal. Shows how much, you know, that he has a kind heart. If people allow him to be who, you know, who he is. And sometimes, you know, people, you know, when he get it, and I seen this myself with the swarm of paparazzi, that's where he gets all built up in anxiety and rush and, you know, people just bothering him. But if folks let him be who he is and be the creative genius that he is, and I do acknowledge that because he's very creative and, you know, whatever, he can do that. And he does have a kind heart to me. I feel that he does. Very creative and smart. Number five, his mother, whose name is Donda, you know, was, you know, the best. He felt that she was the best thing that ever happened to him. And she knew, you know, every lyric to his songs. And number six, he was just a different kind of cat. And lastly, number seven, you know, his confidence and his persistence. And this is what I was saying about, you know, when he had spoken to Oprah, he has very confidence about him, you know. And how, you know, he kept pushing, you know, to go to Rockefeller and all of that. You know, it's inspirational. Like, he wasn't going to stop until he, you know, did that. And people, you know, he just kept getting turned down and this, that, and the third. And so, you know, he had a persistency on, you know, I'm going to do this, that, and the third. And so that's what he did. And again, I haven't seen it, but I you know, took notes and, you know, and pulled this off of Instagram of, you know, what I seen. So, you know, hey, he may be a peculiar kind of cat, but he's a smart dude, but I wish he would get some help when it comes to, you know, what's going on inside his brain. He could still, you know, do some things. And so, yeah. And, that's basically all I have for, you know, this week and inside, Scoop with Rufus News. That's, you know, basically all that I have, you know, for the news. What was that? It just went off. That was a news report. But, yeah, that's all I have. We got, I didn't even tell y'all in the beginning what we got for today. We got, I got, speaking of what's going on for today, we got a Real Talk with Rufus discussion. We're going to talk about finances during the Inside Scoop with Rufus News and how to have a money mindset. How to have a money mindset. And so that's going to help us out on, you know, how to have a money mindset. And you know, the conversation is all going to be, in RH3 show fashion. And so, you know, we're going to get, you know, straight to the point about it. And so, you know, we got 12 points and 12 tips on how to have a money mindset. And so, you know, talk about it. We're going to talk about it and discuss. And we might have it's not a Wellness Wednesday, but you know, we're going to talk about it. And tomorrow, you all, speaking of Wednesday, Hey, we might be here tomorrow with that Wellness Wednesday, but also we're gonna pull a Wellness Wednesday on today. We're gonna do that on today. Alright, so keep it where you got more of the Arch 3 Show is coming up next. Alright, be back in a moment. It's the Arch 3 Show.
Want a free subscription to be a part of our live listening audience? Download one of the major podcast platforms: Google Podcasts, Google Play Music, Apple Podcasts, iTunes, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Radio Public, and more. And search The RH3 Show and subscribe. You'll get all new content as well as access to previously aired broadcasts to listen to, download, and to share to your contacts. We'd love for you to be a part of our family. Subscribe today.
The RH3 Show. For more about the broadcast, please visit therh3show.com.
We gave it a switch. Our lives were in darkness. They came with a switch. So we don't walk like we used to. Talk like we used to. Call us for honor and he'll do it for you too. Yeah.
You ain't got a reason now.
This segment of the RH3 Show provides general information and discussions about health and related subjects. The information and other content provided during this segment or any linked materials on the RH3 Show website are not intended and should not be construed as medical advice, nor is the information a substitute for professional medical expertise or treatment. If you or any other person has a medical concern, you should consult with your health care provider or seek professional medical treatment. Never disregard professional medical advice or delay in seeking it because of something that you have heard on the broadcast or read on the RH3 Show website or any linked materials. If you think you may have a medical emergency, call your doctor or emergency services immediately. The opinions and views expressed during this broadcast or on any future or past broadcast and on the website have no relation to those of any academic, hospital, health practice, or other institution.
All right, you all, we're back for our wellness tip, our health minute. And so we're here to give you some do's and don'ts when someone is in your house that is sick. And like the church folks say, when someone's body is under attack. And so we, you know, we're dealing with a pandemic. We're dealing with some, you know, new ailments and issues every time you turn around. And so we got that person that in the house is strong, and you know, that person that take care of everybody. And so you know, whether if it's the flu, the coronavirus, the Omicron, or whatever it is, the flu virus, the, you know, whatever it is, and we taking care of that person, we got to make sure that we good. And so here are do's and don'ts when someone in your house sick, you got to take care of them. You know, hey, it can be tough, but you know, we have to stay well when we are in close quarters with someone battling coughs and fevers and sniffles or whatever. And so, you know, hey, you know, most of us and some of us can be germaphobes, and you know, all those germs are spreading, and you know, and it's easily to catch, you know, when we are in tight spaces, and you know, it can cause colds, you know, and all of that. But you know, all of this stuff can hang longer than, you know, than usual. But you know, we can protect ourselves, you know, though, if you know, whatever. And so here are some, you know, simple strategies we can try. You can try, you know, when we are around these people. So the do's, you know, will be, of course, naturally wash your hands. And I would say, you know, when you wash your hands with soap and water, you know, say the ABCs. First start off with wetting your hands or whatever, then putting soap in it, and then, you know, continue on saying the ABCs until you know, whatever, wet, soap, and then while you lathering with soap, wet, and then, you know, do that or whatever. But it's just the single best way to avoid a cold. And then once the germs are on your hands, you know, it's easy for them to get into your body when you touch your eyes and your mouth. And so this is another thing people say, well, why folks around here, you know, driving with a mask on? At first I didn't get that, but I do get it now. You know, of course, you know, that's if you don't have walk around here with wipes. But, you know, you say, like, if you go into the grocery store and you have your or to the market or whatever, and you have your mask on, and then, you know, you don't have any gloves on, you touching this and you touching that, and you pushing the cart or whatever, and then you get in your car and you don't have any wipes on, you either you touch your mouth and you touch your eyes, you didn't wash your hands. I get why drivers is driving around in their car with their mask on. You may mistakenly touch your mouth. You may mistakenly touch your eyes. That would be my explanation to them or why people have their mask on when they're driving. It's because they, you know, preventing themselves from touching their mouth. That's it. Preventing themselves from touching their mouth. And that's that. But if you have, you know, wipes or whatever, wipe your hands, you know, with sanitizing wipes. Wipe them very good and then wipe your steering wheel and then take your mask off. But if you choose to have your mask on, have your window roll down. Or have air circulating in there so, you know, you can be good. But if you're taking a risk, if you're taking care of someone who's sick, wash your hands before and after treating them or before and after being with them. But you have to do better than a quick rinse under the faucet. Run your hand together with soap and water. You know, at least for 20 seconds, enough to sing two rounds of happy birthday or your ABCs, like I said. Water, then soap, sing happy birthday or ABCs twice, and then rinse. Don't forget to get between your hand, your crevices of your fingers and your nails and all of that. But remember to keep your hands away from your nose, mouth, face, and ears, you know, all of that. All of that. What else to do? Sanitize your surfaces. Stop the spread of germs means making sure you clean and disinfect hard surfaces such as countertops, tables, refrigerator handles, doorknobs, and faucets, and cabinet knobs, and all of that. Don't forget TV remotes and computer tops and laptops and phones too, and, you know, door handles, all of it. Some germs can live in these spots up for 24 hours. And so just make sure that every part of your home is wiped down and sprayed and Lysoled and, you know, and bleached and all of that. Do it, you know. You know, do all of that by disinfecting, you know, every area using disinfectant or wipes or a quarter cup of bleach mixed with 1 gallon of water. And then, you know, make a spray bottle. Use disposables. Another thing to do is use disposable. Cold or flu germs can cling to, you know, the fabric. So when someone in your house is sick, replace cloth hand towels and dish with rags or washcloth with paper towels. Remove water glasses and, you know, add paper cups in the bathroom and just throw them out. Another thing to do is just bounce and be out the steer clear when you can. It's, you know, to be tough to it's tough to be completely, you know, it can be tough to completely avoid a sick person in your house, especially if you're taking care of them. But be, you know, whatever, have some, those N95, I think that's the name, mask, but then have another mask under it, you know. If you can get their own room and space and have them, you know, in their own room and space to sleep and relax, do that. But when you in there, you know, make sure you are, you know, gloved up, masked up, and all of that. The only person that should go in out of the sick person room is the person taking care of them. Don't have, well, I want to see mama. No, your mama's sick. Get in there and sit down. For real. You just got to tell them that. You know, hey, pamper your immune system. No, that's another thing to do. Hey, you know, have, you know, look for foods that's rich in, you know, vitamins, you know, like vitamin A, which includes sweet potatoes, carrots, spinach, you know, vitamin C, which is citrus fruits, and vitamin E, almonds, sunflower seeds, lean protein, you know, seafood, eggs, beans, well, you know, can also help boost your body's defenses. Make sure you get plenty of rest, daily exercises, keeping stress in check, and limit alcohol, you know, also can help do all of this. You know, hey, there's not much evidence that, you know, what about loading up on vitamin C? I know you may ask that, or other products that boost, they can boost immunity. There's not much evidence that they, you know, they work. Vitamin C supplements might make a cold shorter or milder after you get one, but they can't keep you from getting sick, you know. And this other one is, that's a do, but this one, you know, I it's iffy because, you know, it's up to each individual person, but, you know, flu shots, if you hip to it, do it. If you're not hip to it, that's on you. All of this that I'm reading is all on you. It's all suggested. So, like I said in the disclaimer, consult your doctor, consult your primary care physician, consult who you see on a regular, if you see somebody on a regular, you know. But it takes 2 weeks for the flu vaccine to take effect, and a flu season can last into March or April, you know. But if you're the one that's feeling under the weather, you know, coughing and sneezing your elbow or not your hands. Wash your hands, you know, after you touch your mouth and nose and even the tissue, and as often. And if you are prescribed medicine, finish every bit. And stay in your closed quarters as much as possible. Steer clear of the people that's not sick in your house, because that is selfish. Okay, what I shouldn't do. Don't share foods or drinks or cups or whatever. That's common sense and that's nasty. Don't forget to throw out toothbrushes after everyone gets well. If you sick, throw out your toothbrush. I don't care if you just opened it before you got, you know, whatever. Even that's, you know, for your health, you know, health sake. Don't let everyone share pillows and, you know, blankets with the sick person. It is what it is, you know. Don't let sick and well children share toys. Don't indulge in bad habits like biting your nails, rubbing your eyes, or chewing on pencils. You know, and make it easy for germs to hitch, you know, a ride into your body. Make sure all of this is, you know, of course, you know, done, you know, with care. And then the person that's taking care of you, once, you know, make sure everything is changed in a timely fashion. Don't let a sick person lay in their sick bed often without doing a regular change of their bed sheets and stuff, pillows and stuff. You know, whatever. Again, it's a disclaimer. or whatever, consult your medical doctor, primary care physician, whoever. But, you know, everyone always, you know, take advice of them and use this as a tool to push on and, you know, be better, all right? Be back with more of the Arch Three Show Kitchen Table Talk in just a moment.
Jesus loving you. It sounds crazy, don't it?
Hey, this is Quayla.
This is Isaiah Temple. Hey, family, this is Darius
Parker. I'm Nina Taylor from the Gospel News.
Yo, what's going on? It's your boy Mario J. Brown.
Well, this is Rock River alongside Red.
It's Wednesday.
You are listening to my boy Red with the RH3 Show.
And you're listening to 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 the RH3 Show.
Boss of boss. Oh, yes.
Let me tell you what it does.
All right, pull up a chair. Let's have a conversation. It's time for our kitchen table talk.
We're back for a kitchen table talk. And so this is just where we just sit and chill and enjoy ourselves. And so how have y'all, what's good? What's good? Y'all, we've had a great week so far. Just the second day of the week. So, how have y'all been doing on today? How have y'all day been? What have you all been doing? Listen, y'all. Listen. I've been doing well. It's been a busy week, it's good. Y'all, I usually don't tell the dates on the show, but today is 2/22/22, and so today is a good day. Today is a decision-making day for me and part two of a decision-making day of something that I'm going to decide on doing. And I'm going to just go forward with doing it because it was asked and pressed upon me and I need to be obedient. And some folks may like it, some people may not like it, but hey, it was asked upon me. And I didn't know it was going to be acted upon me. And so, you know, hey, I feel that it was God doing, you know, what he needed. What I feel that it was God answering what I wanted to be heard and God doing whatever. And so, you know, hey, God, look, making a way. He's making a way. He's making a way. And so, hey, look, when God opened a door, run through it, even before your time. Run through it. And so, yeah, I'll let y'all know after a meeting. And so, because a meeting is going to be happened. And so, yeah. But, all is well and all is good. And so, everything is cool and copacetic with me on today. Y'all, listen, I'm going to tell y'all this. Ever since December, and ever since, you know, my procedure in December, ever since that fall that I mentioned, whenever I came back, my sleep, you know, has not been great for the average person. My sleep. But it seemed like the past week, my sleep has been, you know, been coming upon me. And, y'all, I just been tired. Like, I need to turn off my phone. I need to turn off my house phone and just lay down to sleep for a full week without being bothered. You know, I wish I could do that. Like, a full week. Maybe longer and just doze. And because I just feel exhausted, and only because, well, you haven't done that. I know I haven't. Oh, trust. I can tell you that myself. No, I have not. No, I have not. No, I haven't. But the thing is, it's just that I'm catching up on sleep that I lost, because I can, even during that time that I was resting in convalescence, well, you know, from the fall and all of that, I would get at least about what? One to the highest at four. And at four is pushing the hours of sleep. My body. God. Whew. Yeah. And so, even a couple weeks ago, I mean, probably about a week and a half ago, I would be going to sleep about 5:30, 6 o'clock in the morning. Y'all. And so that's that. But, God is good. And so, God is good. And so, y'all, today is 2/22/22. And I just say, you know, just stay positive and stay blessed. And just, you know, before you go to bed, even after this show, pray and, you know, write down some dreams and goals that you want. And just lay it at his feet. Put in the word and then just put your hands on it and say a manifestation prayer and just ask God to bless it, you know. Ask God to move on your behalf. God is good. And so I gotta do what I gotta do. God, you know, hey, God is good. That's all I can say. God is good. God is good. And so, but yeah, my day went well. My day went good yesterday after work. And so, yeah. But, that's, and what I have the rest of the day, not much. And so, I'm just believing God for, God to prosper in my life for the rest of the year, for this show, and for everything else that I got, you know, plans and believing in for. So, you know, that's it. And so, I have nothing else for the kitchen table talk, nothing else to discuss. Mom's birthday tomorrow. So, happy early birthday. I probably won't be able to announce it on tomorrow. Yeah. Yeah, and so that's it for the kitchen table talk. Nothing else to announce, but we're gonna continue to roll on. I think next week or the week after next, we'll be celebrating 500 podcast episodes. And so shout out to us, and you know, whatever. But that's that, and that's all for the kitchen table talk. We good. Y'all good? You good? We good? Let's roll on, all right? So keep it where you got it. More of the RH3 Show is coming up next. And so what we got up next is we got Real Talk with Rufus discussion, and that is a, you know, topic on how to have a money mindset. And you know, we're just gonna talk about it. Talk about it in RH3 Show fashion, you know. Hey, and so we're gonna discuss it and talk about it. So keep it where you got it, all right? More of the RH3 Show is coming up next.
If you're not tuning into the RH3 Show weekly, here's what you've missed.
Because one thing you don't, ladies and gentlemen, one thing that you do not do when you courting fellas, when you courting a lady. Or ladies, when you are seeking or finding a gentleman, if you do not hear anything that I'm telling you in regards to dating or finding somebody at the very beginning of your dating process, you do not listen to me. You do not, not even in the beginning. But throughout your dating, especially in the beginning, that's from the start. In the beginning, you do not let them know in the beginning what you are looking for.
As I say at the end of each broadcast, know that I love you for real. And always remember to live every day, laugh every moment, and love beyond words. Join the RH3 Show family. For more about me or the broadcast, you can visit my website at therh3show.com.
All All right, you all, we're back with our, oh, I knew what I was mentioning, what I meant to mention on the kitchen table talk. Next week, y'all, I was thinking on last, and I meant to mention this on yesterday, but in my planning on last week, and I meant to mention it on Thursday as well, but on next week, I was thinking of something creative to do. All next week, in the beginning of the show, I'm gonna think of some creative ways to, you know, open up the show. And so, we're gonna play a song in the beginning of the show, and we've done it before. Not themed wise. And so, out of even on the best of, which is the Friday show, even on the best of show, the five songs for next week is going to be, it's like a praise and worship type song. And so we're going to pull out five songs for the introduction, not the intro of the song, but to start out the beginning of the show. So every song before the intro of the song of next week is going to be like a praise and worship type song. And so I'll give you one of the songs for next week, because I already, you know, started pulling together our list. So next week, one of the songs is going to be Arise, O God. And that is a song that many churches sing for praise and worship. And so, you know, hey, we're going to have a praise and worship, our theme for next week for our quote-unquote music guest for next week is praise and worship. And so our introduction is going to be praise and worship, and that is going to be the theme for the introduction of our songs for next week. So listen to the song next week and join in, you know, hey, worship God with us. And you know, some of them is going to be fast paced song, you know, one or two maybe going to be, you know, worship songs. And so I love it. You know, we get very creative with this broadcast. And so, you know, join in with us on next week. And so you don't want to miss these songs. And so the five songs that you're going to hear, I've heard them sung during many churches' praise and worship, you know, time. And so I'm like, okay, look, we're going to have a praise and worship moment during the RS3 show. And maybe one or two songs, maybe just one song. And then you're going to hear Jay, our announcer, live from North Carolina. It's the RS3 show. Then after that, I'm like, okay, hey, boom. And so, yeah, so all next week, we're going to do that, and we're going to rock it out, all right? We're going to be leading up to our March Madness month of the RH3 show, all right? How about that? And so, yeah, that is going to be our themed week for next week. Is going to be a praise and worship week on the RH3 show. So, yeah, all right? Let's go ahead and get started with our Real Talk with Rufus discussion. Drop the introduction.
This is real life. We show real love, and we also have real conversations, all from a Christian male perspective. It's the Real Talk with Rufus right here on the RH3 show.
We are here for our Real Talk with Rufus discussion, and we are here to talk about how to have a money mindset. And so, you know, we're talking about finances, and we're talking about how to, you know, even as, you know, adults, and then, you know, some young adults could grasp onto this, on how to have a money mindset. And so, you know, of course, legally, but, you know, if there is, you know, areas, states, you know, places that allow it legally, you know, do it legally. But, you know, make money legally, you know, whatever, do it. And so how to have a money mindset. And so we got 12, you know, tips to have how to 12 tips for you on how to have a money mindset. Number one is to forgive your past. Forgive your past. Anything that you do, you have to inject forgiveness in whatever you do. That forgiveness thing, y'all, can stop whatever you trying to do. Whatever you trying to have, it can stop. It can pump the brakes in whatever you trying to get. So whatever you do before you trying to make money, what if you trying to receive money, forgive your past. Forgive people. It's not for them. It's for you. Forgive your past. Forgive your past. Forgive your past. That's it. Forgive your past. Number two, change your story. What do that mean, Rufus? And some of these is tied into the other, but, and I'll let y'all know, you know, whatever. Change your story. Change your mindset. Change your mindset. Change your story. You could be, you know, either living in poverty. You could not even be living in poverty. You could be living in a, you know, living elsewhere, but, you know, whatever. You could have, you know, a project mentality, or you could have not even a project mentality, a project reality, living in projects. You could, you know, whatever. Change your story. Change how you live in. Have the mindset to change how you live in like this. And when you do, don't look down on that to where you're at. Don't look down on where you're at. But just change your story. Like, okay, I can have better. I can have better. Not that you are better, but just know that you can have better. Change your story. Know that you can change your story. Know that you can change your story. Don't be a woe is me type person. Know that you can change your story. Know that you can have better. You can be better, look better, act better. But you can only, you know, like smoking about only you could prevent forced fire. You can change your story. Number three, practice gratitude. Be thankful. Like the word said, be thankful unto him and bless his holy name. Be thankful. Practice gratitude. You know, whatever you have, be thankful. Okay, y'all, where I first moved to, I had to be thankful, you know, then of, you know, whatever. And, you know, be thankful of what I had. Because God said, you know, if you be, you know, thankful for the least little thing, I'll bless you with much. Practice gratitude. Because God, if you know, you're not thankful and, you know, blessed with just what you have, God, you know, how you can be thankful, you know, with the bigger things. So if you got small, and if you got small and, you know, you're not thankful for that, how God know you're going to be thankful for bigger? Be thankful with least little stuff, and then God will bless you with much. Practice gratitude. Be thankful for the small. Number four, know your worth. Know your worth. Know your worth. Know how much you're worth, and know. Listen. You got to know what you're worth. You got to know that you are, you know, far more worth than what people say you are. Far more worth than how you look. Far more worth than where you're at. You know, whatever. Okay. I might not have Gucci, but I have Uchi. You know? Stunt. Know your worth. I may look. I may have to stunt with the I wouldn't say, you know, cheap jewelry, but inexpensive jewelry. Stunt with that. Number five, believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Believe in yourself. Believe in who you are. Believe in yourself. No, listen, without money or whatever, and because the money is not going to fall on your lap. For some people it do, like, you know what, they walk into it. They pick up a scratch-off card and it just falls into their lap, or somebody just reach over and just bless it. Sometimes money do fall in people's lap, but, you know, you got to believe in yourself that, you know, you can make this money and you can get it, you know, whatever, that you can, you know, flip it. You can do this. You can, you know, you got the brains and knowledge to make your own coins. I could do this. I could turn this business into a multimillionaire business or a billionaire business. I could do this. You got to believe in yourself. Number six, respect and value your money. Respect and value it. You know, hey, you can splurge and do that in the third, but don't disrespect it. Like, you know, if it takes for you to do this, that, and the third, and if it takes for you to, you know, whatever. Okay, whatever, but respect, you know, it give, you know, value it, you know, respect and value it. Don't, you know, abuse it, you know, be wise in spending. And now, you know, I'll talk about that later. Talk about that a little later. So let's move on. Take small steps. Okay, if you have it, like I said, don't go overboard, you know, whatever. Just take small steps in, you know, even when, okay, say like when I was talking about, you know, practicing gratitude. Okay, you know, whenever I first moved there, I was, you know, depressed on, I don't want to live here. Da 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 da. It had to take, you know, small steps to me to appreciate what God had blessed me with. And then, you know, whatever. And then at the time, I think, you know, me living there, I think I purchased, with it being fully furnished, I think I've purchased, let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 5 things out of that place. Everything else was given. Because I practiced gratitude, and then everything else was blessed, you know? That was just me. Number eight, sacrifice leisure. And I'll add this at the end of that, at times. Because, of course, you got to, you can't be, be a tightwad. But sacrifice leisure at times. All right, we're going to take a quick break. We're going to be back with more of the RH3 show. And we'll close out today's broadcast on the next break. But we're talking about how to have a money mindset. And, if you follow these, 12 steps, it'll get you in the start of, being smart with your money. All right? Be back with more of this great broadcast. So keep it where you got it. All right, you all, we're back with our Real Talk with Rufus discussion, and we're talking about how to have a money mindset. And already we talked about forgive your past, change your story, practice gratitude, know your worth, believe in yourself, respect and value money. Number 7, take small steps. Number 8, sacrifice leisure, .. at times. And then number 9, no more complaining. No more complaining. You can't complain. You can't complain. You can't complain. You cannot complain. And then, I know a lot of snooty people with money, complain about this, complain about, look, you have it, Of course, if you're not going to, don't be a tightwad to do that. Number 10, visualize your success. That's where it starts at. That's, if I would have, this probably would have been a number two for me after forgive your past. Visualize your success. Once you visualize your success and know that, where you can get to, that's a start. Like, okay, I'm successful. I see myself in this house. How can I get to that point? Boom, that's a start there. For real. For real. Number 11, never stop learning. Read books on finances, read books on how to save, read books on how to market, read books on how to invest. Never stop learning. Never stop learning. And then number 12, action over excuses. Point blank, period. Actions over excuses. Do. Like they say, faith without works is dead. But then also, you got to have faith. But hope will get you there. It was your faith that made you whole. But it was hope that got you there. But faith, hey, thanks to Apostle Jamila, hashtag CCM Nation for that. Thank you, Apostle Jamila, for that phrase. Thank you for that, for the phrase. And so, we had a great show today. I hope you enjoyed today's show. If you missed it, you can always check us out on podcast platforms or, our YouTube channel. And to those, to answer those who, I like to question, not really question, but, inquire about, my continual discussion on many inside scoop of the Rufus News topics. This broadcast go to, many other stations, podcast platforms, as well as my YouTube channel. And I do hashtags and, the hashtags are searchable. And so, most of these topics that I discuss and talk about are what's being discussed and talked about. And so it just generate buzz. And so that's mainly one reason why, not for me, because honestly, if it was left up to me, I wouldn't talk about it. If left up to me, I just keep it to myself because of, personal reasons. But, I talk about Wendy just to talk about her. I talk about, this topic just to talk about him. I talk about this topic just to talk about him. to generate buzz. And, you know, I do hashtags to, you know, in the description so it could, you know, people can search it. And there it goes, what, the RH3 Show, so other folks could hear it who do not listen to the RH3 Show live. And so that's why I mentioned it on air, so it could generate viewership. It could generate listenerships on other stations, on other podcast platforms, on other social media networks. And so, you know, I don't do it to tickle fancies. I don't do it for, you know, to tickle radio listeners, you know, because if it was left up to me, I wouldn't do it. But I just do it for, you know, entertainment, not only for radio listeners, but for podcast listeners, for not for only podcast listeners, for other social media listeners. And so, hey, that's that. But know that I love you for real. I'll talk to y'all later, and I'll see you all next time right here on the RH3 Show. Peace.
Because the price that he paid for me gave to me my freedom, so I'm not in slavery. Christ made a way for me, grace me, then paid for me a way back to God through the life that he gave for me.
Peace, party people. See you later.
Cause I'm saying bye-bye.
Good night, good night.